Previously on Gladden TV.
Money is the problem. The incentive of money is the problem. Example, there are some people that get salaries of $100,000, $200,000, $300,000 and down, right? If not more. Why would I solve a problem that's gonna put me out of a job? It's that simple. I know y'all know this is a crypto channel, right? And I always gotta get on here and just try to speak some real life shit, you feel me? So I'm gonna start off by saying this. Don't ever wish for something that you know won't benefit you right now. Right? What am I talking about? Like, you know, you could be talking to somebody and they'd be like, man, I wish I had that new truck or something like that, right? They already got a car. Probably even still trying to pay off that car. You know what I'm saying? They just be like, wish I had that new truck. Or I wish I had that new... And they'd be like, okay, think about it. If you had that shit right now, how would that make your life better? You know what I'm saying? Like, you just be a nigga with a truck. Feel me? My bad. So, shit like that, you know what I mean? Trucks, cars, same shit. Trucks, cars, houses, clothes, book bags, laptops, whatever, you name it, you feel me? Don't ever wish for something right now that you know won't benefit you in the long run, you know? That shit is like instant noodles, you feel me? It's cool, damn, I got that shit, but it don't last. It don't last for long, you feel me? The feeling, the excitement, so, yeah. But yeah, y'all, what y'all just seen was, what do you call it? I spent my 4th of July, basically in Long Beach with my girl. And I ran into my dad or whatnot. I just knew he was out there. He loved fishing. He loved the ocean, I just say that. So I knew he was out in Long Beach and shit. So we met up with him. He was with his wife. Good people. Sitting with my dad, you know, my dad, he's been through a lot. You know, so much so, probably things that I'm sure he'll never want to speak about. Me. But yeah, he's changed a lot, a whole lot. And that's just from my perspective, of course. You know what I'm saying? When I say a whole lot, I mean like he's calmed down. You feel me? As far as like he ain't the person he used to be 10 years ago. You feel me? So yeah. Shout out to him. It was good seeing him, good seeing his wife. It's a good vibe overall. Letting my girl get exposed to that type of stuff. And yeah, so I say this also. Crypto space, you know what? I'm gonna go this way. Shit, it's a fucking alley. But yeah, the crypto space, y'all, it feels like it's stagnant right now. You feel me? It's up and down and down and up. Only thing I've been buying, I don't know how long I've been saying this shit, but only thing I've been buying is DigiByte. Mainly because that's the only thing I can afford right now. Some shit happened in my job, or my second job or whatnot. So I'm waiting on a motherfucker to call me to tell me what's the next move. You know what I'm saying? I hate that shit. Hate that for me. So it is what it is. But I'm gonna tell you this: for about $25, you get about 560 DigiBytes. Now I know for a lot of people that's not a lot, but when you already got a fucking huge bag, and you in my situation, that's everything. Cause you like, man, I can afford this. That's 500. You know what I mean? Try buying 500 Litecoins right now for $137. Good luck. Speaking of Litecoin, I was thinking about selling a large amount of my bag of Litecoins for DigiByte. Right? But I think I'm gonna just hold out. I know this Flare Network thing is coming out. I want to kind of see what that's about. You feel me? The whole F assets and Litecoin, XRP, and I think Stellar, if I'm not mistaken, Doge, and so on. But yeah, I'm going to just continue to say it, man. Buy as much as you can for as little as you can. No matter what. You feel me? You see what the fuck I'm going through, right? No, I'm not going through this alley. Well, I'm going through this alley, but that's not what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about, like my little job situation and shit. But just continue to buy, man. And I would say try not to let a week go by without buying something. You feel me? Even if you can't, for whatever reason, afford DigiByte, which you should be able to, you know, because it's still cheap. So yeah, man. Yeah, that's it though, man. Like I said in the beginning, don't wish for something that you know that can't help you in the long run. Only wish for positive things, you know what I'm saying? That can change your life little by little, you know? So you don't have to experience the instant noodles. Yeah, I'm on my way to the gym and shit. About to get it in. And, you know, gotta stay healthy. Gotta stay healthy. Gotta stay active. You got to. Or you don't have to, but I would say you should. But, I'll see y'all next time, man. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. The messages that I tried to sneak in. Other than just all crypto content. Oh, yeah. This is what I wanted to talk about. There's a big disconnect between people who have it and people who don't. People who have money to put money into this crypto space and people who don't have money to put money into this crypto space. I see the disconnect, and I'm sure you do too. Like, you could be like, man, Yeah, I just put in $200-$300 into X, Y, and Z, right? And then you have a motherfucker be like, oh yeah, I just put $3,000-$4,000. You be like, nigga, we from the bottom. Like, you probably have something like that from what you accumulated, but motherfucker, this huge disconnect. I be feeling like, man, this shit is rigged, you feel me? Not just the crypto space, you know, when the prices and shit go up and down, but I be feeling like, yo, this shit is rigged because you got people coming in from the old world, right? Bringing their old money into the new shit, the crypto space, right? Like, you might have inherited a house, or you might have just been good in real estate or whatnot, or whatever the case may be. Probably came in strong with some thousands. You feel me? Like, your start off might have been 40,000. You know what I'm saying? While a motherfucker like me, my startup was like $100. feel me? So it'd be like, yo, this shit rigged. Like, if they could do that, and they're poor, technically. Motherfucker who only got 30,000, 40,000. What the fuck is gonna happen when a nigga that got millions just come in, which they have already have, but I'm talking about all the millionaires, all the motherfucking middle class people. Hopefully the prices go up by then, you know what I'm saying? That's the truth, like, tired of these motherfuckers winning, bro. Just tired of that shit. I know I'm not the only one, but I mean it with that, man. I don't wanna keep ranting, and I gotta save my energy for this gym. So I'll get back to y'all next week, man. Next week, stay strong. Like I said, at least buy something at least once a week. Even if it's just one of something, you feel me? So I'll see y'all next week, man.